Henrietta Swan Leavitt graduated from the Society of Collegiate Instruction for Women, which would later be known as Radcliffe College, in 1892. During her senior year, she took a course in astronomy, which would put her on the path she would follow for the rest of her life. 3 years after graduation, she became a volunteer assistant at the Harvard Observatory, where she would become one of the famous Harvard computers, working under the guidance of Edward Pickering. She worked beside Annie Jump Cannon. Like Cannon, Leavitt suffered a hearing loss due to illness. In 1902, Leavitt would receive a permanent staff appointment. She went beyond the routine work to become the head of the photographic stellar photometry department. Up to that point, stellar magnitude had been determined by the observer, and there was no objective standard of measurement. Pickering sought to remedy this through photographic standardization of stellar magnitudes. He assigned this problem to Leavitt, who began with a sequence of 46 stars near the celestial North Pole. She then expanded this to analysis of more stars in the region. Starting in 1913, and continuing until her death in 1921, she determined the magnitudes for stars in 108 areas of the sky. Her method was the standard for determining stellar magnitudes until technology improved the accuracy of measurements. In her work, she discovered 4 novas and about 2,400 variable stars, more than half of the known variable stars discovered before 1930. One particular kind of variable star that intrigued her was known as a Cepheid variable, named for the star Delta Cephei, a star that was discovered to change in brightness by John Goodrich in 1784. Leavitt discovered that there was a relationship between the brightness of these stars and the period of time between peaks of maximum and minimum brightness. By knowing the intrinsic brightness of a star and measuring its apparent brightness, one could measure the distance to a star with great accuracy. With this cosmic yardstick, she was able to determine the distance to the large and small Magellanic clouds, something previously undetermined because they were too distant for parallax measurement to determine. Edwin Hubble used Leavitt's method to measure the distance to what was then called a spiral nebula, M31, in the constellation Andromeda. There had been considerable debate about the nature of these nebulae and whether they were inside the Milky Way galaxy or beyond it. At a distance of 2.2 million light years, Hubble realized that it was a separate galaxy. All of Hubble's subsequent work would be built on the foundation put down by Leavitt. Hubble often said that she deserved the Nobel Prize for her work. By paving the way for modern astronomy to understand the true scale of the universe, Henrietta Swan Leavitt forever changed our understanding of the cosmos, which is why she's the Planet of Mystery Cool Astronomy Person of the Week.